Hey, it's Jason, House of Jacobs Gaming again. We are on day two of the Fallout Fridge project. So the primer's all done up, and as you can see, we got some of the spots where it's just kind of rough, right? But it's a primer, so I kind of expected that. It's not a gloss. And we're going to go to the next stage. Problem is, I use that whole can of primer, so I'm really hoping each of these is enough. So now I'm going to go do like a metallic color, and then follow that up with a gloss. But there's gonna be a little step in between that I kinda picked up from another YouTuber that I was watching for making it to where we can flake this red off and make it kinda battle damage. So I'm gonna start on the second or the next coat, which is more of a metallic, bright metallic color. So let's see how it goes. Now we let it dry for a bit. This can is almost out already, so we're only going to be able to hit up certain spots after this. But we'll let it dry, and I'll come back and do another coat in about 30-40 minutes. Alright gang, so I've got my base coat on, so it's nice metal-y looking, right? I don't like how this is doing this though. So I know the clear coat when you get done will make it nice and smooth, but that's kind of bothering me. But I know it's darker under those spots. And I would go with another can, but I just don't have one. And this is really only on here to do one thing. Because I would have just done it in red. My headset's still on. I would have just done it in red and been done with it. But this is here, so that way when I go to do the chipping of the paint, that there will be metal underneath. It'll look like metal underneath. So I've done the etching, I've done the primer, or I've done the etching primer, and I've also put this base coat on. So now before we go and put the red on, I'm going to show you a little trick that I picked up off YouTube from Jay's Two Cents when it comes to if you want to actually chip something without masking it off. Like I'm sure there's people that can mask it off good and all that stuff, but this looked like a much easier way to do it. And I'm going to do two things before I put the red down. One, I'm going to put in some of the corners and stuff this black paint. So that way when I paint the red over top of it, it'll be darker in those spots. It'll look like there's corrosion underneath the paint. Okay? Because that's what happens. You get corrosion underneath paint. It starts to darken and lift up. It's not actually going to lift up because this is paint and we're just making the effect. But the second one is hairspray. Jason, why do you need hairspray? Well, let me explain how it was explained to me. All right, so what you're gonna do is along the edges, or basically wherever you don't want the next layer of paint to stick, you're going to spray hairspray. So I would spray mine along this edge, and then what I would do is peel it up. Now, I want my edge to be out here because this will be this one. Anywhere where I have dents in this, like, I actually have dents in here just because the fridge is old. So anywhere it's dented, I'm going to spray some hairspray, and I'll chip it up there. And then you'll have this, like, metallic-looking stuff underneath. And even though this is darker here and darker here, it'll look more like corrosion, too, I think. So hairspray, and then I'll show you that after I go to try and peel it up. And hey, it might work, it might not. I've never done it before, so we'll both get to see together. But this is something I picked up. And I guess he didn't specify what kind of hairspray, so I just borrowed my wife's. And I'm not going to use a ton of it. So I'll show you what I'm going to do and where I'm going to put it, and we'll see what happens next. So like I said, you'll end up with corrosion on the edges first, so that's where I'm putting this black. So I put on the hairspray along the edges on stuff, so I'll have a spot to kind of pick it out. And I put some black on the corners. I won't put any here. Maybe it stays nice. I don't know. Maybe that's just a whole bunch of chipping. And I did the same thing on these, on the top corner, top. So when I put the red down, that should be darker, and that will look like that corrosion I was talking about. So I'm going to put down the red, and we'll kind of see where we're at the end of the day. All right, gang, this is how far I got today. I ran out of red paint. I need to get another can. But if you see how this kind of comes through, I did a real light coat of red over that. I'm thinking that I'm going to put another layer of black and then another light coat of red, only because I want to make sure that I got it nice and glossy looking. Even though it's supposed to be beat up, I still want it to be kind of shinier. And the same thing over here. See what happens when you can actually spray over the black, and then all of it goes away. But I do like how this came out and this side came out. So I got I think you just have to work with the spray a little bit to see which way you like it the best, how much deterioration or corrosion you want underneath. So I'm gonna have to keep working with it. I really do need another can though, because there's still spots where it's not glossy. Like you can see, like right here, I didn't get it all the way. And then I sprayed too much there because that was the last of it. So one more can, and then some chipping is all we need to do. And then when we get to the clear coat and the vinyl, I guess that'll be a whole other video. So I'll show you what, we'll recap what all's gone on in the next video. But like I said, if you want to keep seeing more stuff like this, hit that subscribe button. Hit the little bell to let you know when we do more videos. But it'll probably be a couple days before you see another one of these, because I have to get all the rest of the materials. So thank you guys very much, and I'll see you next time on House of Jacobs Gaming Builds. Dang, this thing is hard to open.